Good morning. Welcome to worship and happy Easter to all of you. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. And now you're invited to rise from your chairs and turn to those that are with you and around you. Welcome each other to worship and share God's peace. Please pray with me. God of mercy, we no longer look for Jesus among the dead, for he is alive and has become the Lord of life. Increase in our minds and hearts the risen life we share with Christ, and help us to grow as your people toward the fullness of eternal life with you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, whom with you and the Holy Spirit we worship and praise, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading comes from Acts chapter 10, verses 34 through 43. Then Peter began to speak to them. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced. How God had anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear. Not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The next reading is from Psalm 18. You will echo the first four lines after me, and then I will finish the last three. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Here end the readings.
On the drums this morning, and to Owen and JJ on their trumpets for adding to our service.
Hallelujah.
Hey, some of you guys need to come back up for our children's message. And all of the kids, come and join me up here, would you? I've got an Easter gift here in my children's message. Do you guys give gifts at Easter? Do you guys give gifts at Easter? I usually think of gifts giving at Christmas. And at Christmas, the gifts are all wrapped up really nice. Would you get excited about this if it was under the tree? Would you? Oh, good. Because, yeah. Usually, the Christmas gifts are wrapped in really pretty paper, and they're all fancy, but this is kind of plain, isn't it? It's just sort of a box. It's not very exciting. But I think this is a really good Easter gift, because the gift of Easter comes to us in something kind of like this box. A tomb. A tomb. It's just sort of a hole in a side of a hill. It's sort of like a cave. And that's what Easter's gift is to us. So, what do you think a good Easter gift would be? Do you think like an Easter egg the size of this box that's all chocolate? Would that be good? Or like even chocolate and filled with marshmallow cream, that'd be good, right? Lots of different kinds of, like maybe Reese's bars or Reese's cups, or like shaped like an Easter bunny, so there's more peanut butter to chocolate ratio, right? I mean, there's a lot of good things that could be in an Easter gift. So what do you think our Easter gift is? You ready? Surprise! It's empty! Did somebody steal it? Did you guys come up here before the service? You know what? This is a perfect Easter gift. Because the greatest gift of all to us at Easter is an empty tomb. So it's really good to have an empty box as a present, isn't it? The tomb is empty. That means Jesus has risen from the dead. He's come out of the tomb back into the world. And Jesus comes to meet you and me and to live with us every day and help us. That is a wonderful gift. An empty tomb is about the best thing you could ever hope for on Easter. So let's pray and thank Jesus, okay? Let's fold our hands, bow our heads, and you repeat after me, and the congregation will join you. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for this Easter gift, an empty tomb. Thank you for your resurrection that was for us to defeat the power of death and bring us eternal life. Thank you for all your gifts. And in your name we pray. And all together, God's children say, Amen. All right. Thanks for coming up and happy Easter, you guys. The Easter story this year comes to us from Matthew chapter 28. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, He has been raised from the dead, and indeed, he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you. So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." I'm sure you heard about that early Easter morning when St. Peter met three brand new souls at the pearly gates. He said to them, "I can let you in if you can answer one simple question." And so the first in line stepped up and St. Peter said, "What is Easter?" And the guy said, "Oh, Easter is a holiday that people celebrate in November. They all get together, they eat turkey, and they thank God for all the blessings in their life." And St. Peter just, "No, no, no." Second guy steps, "What is Easter?" And the second guy starts and he said, "Oh, Easter is a celebration in December where everybody puts up these really nice trees. They buy gifts for each other. They exchange gifts all to celebrate that Jesus Christ was born." No, no, no. His third guy steps up. St. Peter says, "What is Easter?" And the guy says, "Oh," being a good Lutheran, he knew the answer. He said, "Oh, Easter is a Christian holiday that coincides with the Passover. Jesus celebrated the Passover with his disciples and then later was betrayed by one of them. He was handed over to the Roman guards who beat him and whipped him. They put a crown of thorns on his head and then eventually they hung him on a cross, stabbed him with a spear, and then finally, as he was dying, Jesus said, "It is finished." They took his body down and they put it in a tomb. And then they rolled a gigantic stone over the top of the stone, off of the tomb to seal it. And by this time, you can imagine St. Peter's going, "Yes, yes," got a big smile on his face. And the guy continues on. And now, on Easter morning, Christians around the world gather to celebrate Jesus' resurrection. The stone has been rolled away, and Jesus has come out of the tomb. And if he sees his shadow, there's going to be 6 more weeks of winter. You know what Easter's about, at least. Easter's about God's victory over the powers of evil. It's God's victory over sin, death, and the devil. On the cross, Jesus paid for our sins, the penalty of our turning away from God. And on the cross, Jesus paid for that we might have the forgiveness of all of our sin. And in that death, sin is defeated. From the cross, Jesus descended into hell, and at the very gates, he broke open the gates of hell. He went into hell, and he set all of the prisoners free. And in that, the evil one is defeated. And Jesus rose from the dead to bring you and me the gift of eternal life and to defeat the power of death. We gather together on Easter morning to celebrate that Jesus has defeated the power of sin, death, and the devil. Jesus has overcome the power of evil. That's Easter. But in this Easter story that we read for this morning, there's a more personal message. There's a message in this story for you. Whoever you are, wherever you are, this Easter morning, there's a personal message just for you. On that first Easter, the disciples were surprised. They were surprised there was nothing in the tomb. They were surprised it was empty. They were surprised by the resurrection. The disciples thought it was all over. As far as they were concerned, they saw Jesus die on a cross. He was gone. The mission, the preaching, all of the miracles, all of the good. It was over for the disciples. They were surprised on that Easter morning. Did you hear the first thing that came out of Jesus' mouth? Did you notice it in our scripture story? It was a message just for the disciples. And it's a message for you and me today. You see, the disciples had failed Jesus miserably. On that Good Friday, after they celebrated the Passover meal, one of them betrayed him, and all of the rest of them ran away. We know the story of Peter because he gets all the publicity. He denied Jesus 3 times, the cock crows, all of that stuff. But all of the other disciples failed Jesus as well. They all turned their back on him. Earlier in the Gospel of Matthew, we hear these words. They all forsook him and fled. That was in the garden. When the Roman soldiers came to arrest Jesus, all those disciples that had been with him and had seen everything, they all turned and ran. They were out to save themselves, to do what was best in their eyes, to do what was best for them. They forsook him and fled. It's not just Peter who failed Jesus. All of those disciples failed Jesus miserably. And yet, on this first Easter morning, we see it in this passage of Scripture. Jesus had a message, personal message, for those disciples, and it's a personal message for you and me. Anybody notice what the first words were out of Jesus' mouth? Well, somewhere along the line, I heard about this Sunday school teacher who was trying to teach her kids about the resurrection and about the empty tomb and all of that. And so she went through the whole Good Friday story. Jesus was taken captive. He's whipped and beaten. He's hung on the cross. He dies. They put him in a tomb. They roll a gigantic stone over it. And then she starts getting excited and telling the kids about the resurrection. And the stone has been rolled away, and Jesus has come out of the tomb. And does anybody know the first words out of Jesus' mouth? And one little girl in the back of the Sunday school, I know. And the teacher says, okay, tell us, what did Jesus say? And she hops out of her chair and she goes, ta-da! Do you know what Jesus did say? He said, don't be afraid. I'll meet you in Galilee. Don't be afraid. I'll meet you in Galilee. And that was a message to the very people who turned their back on him and ran away to save themselves. When Jesus came out of the tomb, that's who he was thinking of. All of those ones that had failed him and turned away. And Jesus had a message for them. Don't be afraid. I'm going to Galilee. Go there too. I will meet you and we'll be together there. You know, it's not just the disciples that failed Jesus miserably. You and I have failed Jesus as well. We've failed him in lots of ways, each of us in our own ways, but we've all failed Jesus in our thoughts, our words, our deeds, things we've done, things we've failed to do. We're just like the disciples. And just like the disciples, Jesus has a message for you today. Regardless of what your failure is, regardless of where you've been, regardless of how far you ran, Jesus has a message today, and that is, with open arms, Jesus says, don't be afraid. I will meet you. Today, on this Easter morning, Jesus is thinking of you, and just like the disciples that day, Jesus says, come back. It doesn't matter how far you fled. It doesn't matter what you've done. Jesus says, come back to me. You know, it's not every day you find someone who will give you a second chance, much less find someone who will give you a second chance every day. But that's Jesus. And that's Jesus' message to you today. This is a second chance. Don't go home indifferent to Easter. Don't go home forgetting about Jesus' resurrection. His message is for you. Welcome back. Come. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for the resurrection where we see for us, on our behalf, you have defeated the power of sin, death, and the devil. But Jesus, thank you for this message that regardless of where we've been, you welcome us back just like the disciples. Thank you, Jesus. In your name we pray. Amen. And now I invite you to join me in confessing that Christian faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The response today is, hear our prayer. United in the hope and joy of the resurrection, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. You call your church to witness to your salvation. We give thanks for all the theologians, preachers, and teachers who proclaim your gospel. Equip all the baptized to share the joy of the resurrection in all we say and do. Risen Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You bring fundamental life throughout creation. The green blade rises and all creation greets the resurrection dawn. Preserve vineyards and orchards and those who tend them. Feed us with the fruits of creation. Risen Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You show your steadfast love without regard to borders, barriers, or human-made divisions. Infuse your justice in every nation of the world, that all experience the peace that only you can give. Risen Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You anointed your Son with the Holy Spirit and with power. Encourage us by his example in our ministries of healing, care, and outreach. We pray for all who are sick or hospitalized, especially Claire, Brett, Barb, Dennis, Destiny, Kim, and Brenda, and for all health care workers who care for them. Risen Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have put gladness in our hearts. Inspire musicians and dancers to rejoice with songs of victory. Bless the music ministries of this congregation and all who foster our assembly's song. Risen Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As you have raised Jesus from the dead, you show us your resurrection promise. With your holy ones, you have sung your praise. Free us from fear and empower us to go and tell the good news. Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear.
Rejoicing in the victory of Christ's resurrection, we lift our prayers and praise you, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Invited to come forward to receive the bread and wine, the body and blood of Christ, as we celebrate communion on this resurrection day. Today we will be serving by intinction, which means you'll receive a wafer, take that wafer and dip it in either the wine, the dark beverage, or the alcohol-free wine, the lighter colored beverage. So the chalice will have two separate sections. Choose the one you want, dip the wafer, and then eat and drink together. The side sections, you'll come around the back to the center aisle. Everybody come to the center aisle and return by the outside aisle to your place. We're reminded of on the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you." After supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." We pray as Jesus taught the disciples, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. this table and nourish us with the food and drink of the promised land. When we have participated in this meal, send us forth into the world that we may be witnesses to your resurrection life. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless and keep you as you go. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. I invite you to sing for our closing song.